So, last year, in September, we had, this one weekend, we had 7 dogs at our house. We didn't know any of them, they just drove up. Bert was a barker breakfast. Now we have, well, I'm so used to saying we have 3 dogs, because we did until recently, but our oldest dog, a Chinook named Tanner, who was 15, and a Chinook is a big dog. He passed on. So now, but at that time we had our 2 Chinooks, Tanner, who was 15, or actually he was 14 last year. And our younger Chinook, Finn, is 3. And then our little dog is 13, she's a little Jack Russell. Her name is Kitty. And I know, I got a lot of grief for naming the dog Kitty, but it is a name as well as a noun, right? Had an Aunt Kitty, we were never confused. She didn't talk funny though. So aside from our 3 dogs, we had 4 visiting poodles, all belonging to members of one large extended family with whom we're quite friendly. So there were 4 poodles, but there was 1 standard poodle named Cielo, and of course I know that at least standard poodles are said to be super smart, and I can assure you that this assessment was not made on the basis of Cielo. Cielo is not smart. He's not smart. His favorite things to do are to chase the ball, well, hump things, chase the ball and eat toilet paper. Not off the roll, but out of the trash can. And then you find it in the yard and it's just unimaginably gross once it's, it's really delightful. So you have to keep all the bathroom doors closed and come around. And then there were 2 Moyen poodles, our kind of mid-sized poodle. There was Willow, who's 5, who also likes to play ball and eat toilet paper. I was saying I'm not going to get a poodle unless I get a bidet. But this is so French. But I'm thinking if you had a bidet, you'd probably still need to dry yourself off right now. And then the last poodle, be an interesting book title, I'm not going to get a poodle. The last poodle was a little eeny weeny poodle, who, if you saw him, you would agree with me, I promise you, he is the reincarnation of Paul Lind. I don't know why, but he is. Every time I see him, I'm like, it's Paul Lind. So it's a bit much having 7 dogs in the house. A little tiny dog thing is licorice. And it's just nuts, you know. And Licorice and Kitty also thought it was ridiculous. They were like, get these dogs out of here. And anyway, so that weekend, the Sunday of that weekend, I had a show down in Ringwood, New Jersey. And I live in Swansea, Massachusetts, which is down near Fall River, between Fall River and Providence. And so I had to be in Ringwood for a sound check at like, noon or 1 or something. And that's, just hideous to a folk singer, right? And to have to actually do anything before noon. And so I was kind of feeling sorry for myself. I had to leave the house at 9 in the morning. And I thought, Cheryl, most people have to be where they're going at 9 in the morning, so why don't you just shut up? And it reminded me, one time I was on my way to Gave Up in Vain, and it was the 5th one in a row. And that doesn't usually happen, and I was like ticked about it. And I was driving, and out loud in the car, I said, who the hell works 5 days in a row? And then I was like, everyone, Cheryl, everyone! And for more than an hour and 15 minutes, shut up, Cheryl. So anyway, on a Ringwood, New Jersey day, I, for some reason, had occasion to recall a dream that I had had years before, and in that dream, I was flying a huge airplane. Apparently, this is how I fly an airplane, by the way. Which may have been why there were no passengers. Anyway, and it was a DC-3. I didn't know I knew what a DC-3 was until I was having this dream. They always sat like that on the tarmac. They were big propeller planes, but they were passenger planes. And I'm flying this thing. And you know how real dreams are when you're having them, right? I'm like, oh my God, I'm flying this huge plane. I landed it in a field, dark, no lights, but I seemed to know what I was doing. And I got out of the plane. plane, and I walked away from it, and I looked back and realized that it was an inflatable plane. Just what a handy idea. So, anyway, the inflatable plane and the seven dogs came together for this little number. My inflatable plane goes flying.